What's going on? So today embarks a really awesome day for me because about a year ago, around this time, is when I actually bought this 2005 Subaru WRX STI. So I'm going to be sharing my 1 year review with you guys and we'll see all my thoughts about the car and whatnot. So yeah, so right now the car is mainly stock. It just has a downpipe, catback, and a short ram intake on the car. So basically this is going to be a review for a car that's pretty much stock. So yeah, for a car being 13 years old right now, I'm surprised I bought a car that was really close to stock. So I was pretty amazed by that because I did want to have to mod it all myself and do all the work myself. So I'm really glad I bought this one. Yeah, I'm gonna be that weird dude with a camera on his face. Yeah, so first of all, I'll just start off with the interior because that's what you look at every single day if this is your daily, which it is mine. Yeah, so for this being a 2005, this interior is actually not too bad. It's basically all plastic, which I'm fine with. I don't need any high-class luxury interior details. I just need it to work. And that's what's great about this car, is everything works, and it's in a good place. And it doesn't look like total crap. So that's what I enjoy about this. The gauge cluster itself is really nice. I like how the tachometer is right in front of you, so you can actually see what your RPMs are instead of how fast you're going, because you want to shift at an awesome time just to get those nice clean accelerations. Yeah, so the previous owner did plasti dip this car. It was all accented white, which actually looks pretty nice, so I'm gonna actually keep that look right now. And yeah, I do enjoy it. Yeah, these seats, they're actually not too bad for being stock. For me being a very tiny guy, they don't really hold me in that well to compare to someone who actually does fit these nice. But for actually being stock seats, they actually hold you in pretty nice as well. So yeah, when you're sitting in the driver's seat, when you look straight forward, you actually see that big hood scoop right up there, which tells you something, that there's something pretty special going on under the hood there. And also when you look in the rear view mirror, you see that big giant wing, you know you're driving a nice fast car. That's what everyone would say. So yeah, the exterior on this car is pretty nice as well. So yeah, this is my favorite chassis type of the older Subarus, is the blob eye. It makes it look really aggressive. That front bumper is spot on for me. The hood scoop is the biggest hood scoop that I've seen on the STIs. And also that big giant wing you see back there. It just makes the car look so mean, so aggressive. And anytime you see it around, you know it's just really iconic. It's a really iconic car. You can notice it from a mile away and you know it's a Subaru. So another thing while we're talking about the interior or exterior, whatever you want to call it, is basically this is a four-door sedan, so you can daily it. You can have people come in and out with comfort, which is a huge pain if you do have a coupe, which either the driver or the passenger is going to have to get out of their car and have to let the people out of the back. It's pretty annoying. One thing is, if you're wanting to get this as a daily car, your miles per gallon is gonna suffer. This is not a very economy car, obviously, because it has a turbo. Yeah, so if you're looking for any type of fuel economy car, this is not the car for you. This is for basically having fun on the road and also having that convenience of a four-door sedan with you at all times. The only downside is that the back seats don't fold down on you. So if you wanna get something long in, like snowboards, bikes, well, bikes no matter what, but you're gonna have to get a roof rack for that, which I'm gonna have to get as well because I love to snowboard. It's probably one of my favorite sports of all time. So yeah, so this car comes equipped with a center differential thing. I don't know what you actually call it. It's the DCCD on the car right there. And if I just hit this switch right here, you can actually see that it'll actually put 60% of the torque to the back wheels and then 40% up to the front. Or if you want to go 50-50 split, you just push the wheel forward and it'll go 50-50 all the way to lock, which you don't want to do. There's really no instance where you want to fully lock it. But other than that, I like how you can differentiate where the power is going to be for the drivetrain and whatnot. So another great thing about this car is you get all these awesome sounds along with the turbo that goes inside your car. You get the blow-off valve, you get the turbo whistle, you get the wastegate. It's just all nicely packaged into one form. You get all these awesome sounds, which is perfect for me. Commonly known for the Subarus is the boxer engine with the unequal length headers, which gets you that awesome rumble sound, which you are hearing right now. And stock version, you don't get a nice rumble sound because with the stock exhaust, it's not really that loud, so you can't really hear it. If you want to actually get the full effect of the exhaust, you want to go for at least a cat-back exhaust so you can actually hear the nice rumble. And I like how that sound differentiates from every other import car as well, because with the sound and the look, you just get something completely unique that no one else has, which is pretty awesome. I'm probably getting so many weird stares right now. This guy has a weird camera on his face. He's talking to himself. Oh well. And oftentimes when you downshift, you'll get these awesome pops and cracks from the exhaust. Sometimes backfires as well, or if you want to call it afterfires, which are actually called. I don't know which one they're called, but and it creates a nice loud sound, which I am all for. I'm all for these loud sounds, obnoxious cars. That's all me, man. Let's do a little pull right here. Why not? So that was just a second gear pull. Got a nice backfire there. So yeah, with this car, turbo lag's actually not too bad, as everyone does say. I see it around 3 to 350 RPM. It's actually pretty responsive in this car. And I like how the power band's really linear. So pretty much once you're on boost, it stays at that peak. It doesn't drop off. It doesn't spike anywhere. It's nice and linear. So if you're doing any fun roads, back roads and whatnot, you won't get any hit with that instant boost that you won't be expecting. So we're just gonna be testing out the handling for my car. We're just gonna be going through some nice quick turns in here and we'll see how she reacts. So basically, since this is an all-wheel drive car, turning is a little bit different. If you keep your accelerator on, you'll be good, but if you're let off the throttle a little early, you'll start to oversteer a bit and then understeer. It's a little weird because it'll kind of try and overcorrect itself, and then since all the weight's all in the front, you'll lose grip that way, and then you'll just understeer, which is terrible. So yeah, just keep the throttle whenever you're going through these turns. There we go. So yeah, she handles pretty well, I gotta say, just for being stock. But since there is that little problem, there are a lot of aftermarket fixes that you can do to the car, which will help stiffen up your chassis and help with that understeer for the car. So yeah, otherwise handling is great for this. I love it. As long as you keep the throttle while you're turning, you'll have no problems. All right, just gonna do a second gear pull here and we'll just lay it out all the way through. It's pretty decently fast for comparing to stock, so it's pretty good, gotta say. But that's only the beginning. I'm gonna be trying to get this car up to 600 horsepower. So that is my eternal goal with this. So if you guys wanna keep watching or find out how I actually do it, yeah, you can stay tuned. Yeah, I'll be making video progress the whole way through, showing guys what I put on the car, so there'll be no part on the car that you guys won't see. The only couple of downfalls I have with this car is the understeer that you get when you lift off the throttle, because it is all-wheel drive. So that's number one. And number two is, if you ever heard of a Subaru, you've probably heard of ringland failure. So if you don't know what that is, that's pretty much excess oil in the engine blowing by into your vent valves, going straight back into your intake, through your turbo, in your cooler, and then back into your combustion chamber, which is not good at all. So I do have an aftermarket air oil separator, which I do recommend if you do have a Subaru or literally any turbocharged car at all, if you want to save it. Preventive maintenance, if you want to call it. But essentially, you do need an air oil separator or at least a catch can just to make sure no oil or minimal amount of oil goes inside your intake, because you don't want that to happen. It'll bring down the life expectancy of your engine, and of course you don't want that. So those are the only two things that I don't like about this car. Every other thing is, it's perfect. I couldn't ask for anything more. This feels like a race car. It was intended to be race car like, and that's what they delivered. So yeah, I'm not gonna be selling this car. I'm gonna be driving it into the ground, if you want to say so. If you guys want to keep up to date, go ahead and subscribe. That'd be awesome. And I also hope to see you guys in the next video. So see you guys later.